Join back. I'll send you the image also. Now switch off sock selection. Okay, so I'll just give me a second, I'll send you the image in chat. I have sent the image in chat. You can download it from there. So match all the sheep. If required, slightly move it forward for balancing. So I can see I have this shape, and if I want to go back to line, I can just press yes and hold, go back to line. And if you see this width, this width, angle, all these things are there. If I use a radial, it's too much. No, I'll go to rectangle only. That will be nice. I got the basic shape, everything, whatever I modify, back to that thing only. I need this extruded area. So I need to create that shape and twist. Let me see. I have a twist. See, I can twist it like this. So I feel, because I need this one section, another section, and another section. So what I'll do, I'll create this shape. You see, yeah, I'll create this shape and then I'll twist it. So first thing first, I need this shape here. So for this, I need to generate this box. I select all the polygons down here. Delete, like, do not select this thing. Oh. My bad, I should have deleted this one and this one so that there is no continuation loop. Continue, and then I need to extrude this to create this shape. Front, I can see this. Extrude. Click this extrude. And then move it. Basic structure. Delete this one. Delete this one. Oh, Ashwin is joining. Before that, I can do one more thing. As I feel there should be enough edges, there's not enough edges, so I'll just simply select this, chamfer it, add more edges. Now I have more edges to work with. And now my basic shape. My first part is ready. Now my second part, polygon. So you can see, if I extrude it like this, it's not perfectly aligned. So I click on the setting and changes to local normal and then extrude. So you can see evenly throughout it extrude this thing, front, vertex, basic shape. Similarly, I need to create this shape also. So I align this with this. All these edges, I'm aligning them nicely. Now, polygon, except this one. Extrude again. We'll take the last setting, front, vertex. Okay, you see, I got the steps and everything, but my backside is kind of twisted and my backside also kind of same. So my easiest way of creating this thing will be, if I create this thing in symmetry, if I create a symmetrical shape, if I create a symmetrical shape, so, and then twist it, I'll get this shape very easily. So select these two edges, bridge them, like basically close the shape. Now these two edges, bridge them, close the shape. Now the basic shape is ready, front. And I can see there is a twist, plus there is a twist, and there is this, all these lines are there following throughout. So what I'll do is I'll create this thing in symmetry, SY, press symmetry, apply a symmetry modifier. If I want, I can flip it, or if I keep it like this, weld seam, slice, if I don't want any slice. I'll create this basic shape. You can see my shape is ready, but it's not nice. It's not correct. Same thing I have to do for the back also. Okay, polygon. Sorry, polygons. Delete this. A similar angles, but only thing now I can see, I cannot see through the image. So how to fix it? So right now I have to apply a material, like any material. Just make sure any material, drag drop it here. I want to see the wireframe, but I want to see the image also, but I don't want to see the solid color. So I'll go, you can see there is something called opacity. It's 100%. Just reduce it, like maybe 30-40%. So you can see through the shape. And I can see it doesn't align with my entire shape. So I just simply lock out the entire object nicely. Align them nicely. And this side is not visible, so it's my fault. Of course, history. Why this thing is like this? Just give me a second. Customization, preferences, undo is like only 20. So I increase the undo level. It was under customization. preferences. So undo was really low, so it's become very difficult for me to align or match anything. Okay, so one more thing I can do is polygon, delete the half, because this is also I need to match. So align them very nicely.
Oh, hi, sir. Hello. Oh, sir, can you hear me?
That distance I have to reduce. This is fine.
So
I got this basic structure. Now I'm thinking of to duplicate this and align. Sir, may no audio.
Okay. So I have one doubt. Hello.
What happened? Am I not audible?
Hello.
Then what happened? Okay, I'm not able to help you. Just give me a second. I guess Zoom have a setting that I check. Optimize video, share sound. Okay, speaker is. I guess now I should be able to hear you. I guess there was a little setting change in. I guess I should be able to hear you now.
Hello.
I can hear you. Yes.
Okay. Actually, I tried 3-4 times, but you were not able to hear me.
Okay.
So actually, I have one doubt. So when we are using the front mode. When you are deleting it, when you are deleting the vertex, so automatically the backside is also getting deleted.
Yes, if I drag and select, then it will delete the back front and back both. If I just click on any side, it will delete only and only that particular face. If you drag it, it will basically select front side and back side, both the sides. That's what I'm doing.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome. 90. Okay, it should be 0. Correct. Now, I want to put it in this direction. Okay. So, for rotation, I can switch in my angle rotation. Right click, and you can see the properties. 5 degree, you can make it 90, and just simply rotate. So why I did this? So that my front and back can be exactly the same width-wise, and I can use the same shape again. instead of recreating the shape again and again. So right now there are two different shapes. Resize it. And now I want to place them properly. Vertex. I can see the entire thing, rotation, rotate, and place it. Now again, if you press Alt and click on this, it will deselect it. Rotation, selected. And I can see a lot of distance, so that is something I need to cover. And fix all of them. Nicely. Now this is my first point. Select this, rotate it again. All right, select everything correctly. Move it down. I'm just matching the shape. Shape. Distance, and these two are separate now, but if I want to fix them, I have to fix, like, align them nicely, then fix it. So what I'll do, I'll go to attach and click on this. Now both are attached, but I need to weld them together and fix everything. So select these two, or maybe not like this. Select this vertex, target weld. Click on this vertex and click here. So I'm target welding everything. Right click, I want to see this only, hide unselected, and fix it. Everything is combined now. Material, I can go and make sure transparency is full 100%. Hide all and hide all. Now I got that basic structure, front. Now I'll align all of them nicely. align all the angles. Basic shape. Now, if I want, I can use twist. Not in Z. Not in Y. So I can see there is a like position wise angle distortion. So what I have to do is first I have to fix the pivot point, send it to the object, but still it have all those history of distortion, all these things. So go to your last option, utilities. There is something called a reset X form. Click on this. Now click on reset selected and now you have reset X form. Right click. Collapse all. So all history or everything will be gone now, and now I can use twist. See, now it's like perfectly fits my shape, and now if I want to twist something, you can definitely do it very easily. So here I can like twist it, but only thing is you can see this is twisting the entire thing. So if I click on the limit, upper limit, like where it's going to affect, like the which direction. So upper limit, I can switch the lower limit, so it will affect only lower limit. Upper limit you won't affect. Same only, no difference. Everything is blocked, everything is there. And apply a turbo and smoothing group. So basic shape is almost ready. All the shape, all the design, everything is ready. Front. This one cylinder is required, so I can create any cylinder, or if I want, I can extrude it from this shape. From this shape only, extrude. Perfect straight line. Now I want to make it a little smoother and nice. So clear all polygon smoothing group, auto smooth, apply, and then apply a turbo smooth. And click on smoothing group to retain and apply one more turbo, or this is like kind of fine. You can see it create a nice shape. That nice shape. I can see this is like slightly deformed. Go back to my shape. I can see slightly a slight issue here. Vertices. Push them in the center. Align it nicely. Everything like alignment nicely, and then go back to a turbo. So it will create everything smooth and soft. So in basic structure wise, you can see if we shift F and material, reset entire material and select this to everything. It applies this to everything. This is like apply. applied to everything, and this entire thing I need to rotate multiple times. So what I have to do is apply edit poly. One more time to this, attach and attach. So all three are attached. Now I have to, well, you can see there's 8 of this lamp. I need to duplicate this. So first thing first, what I'll do, I'll make sure my pivot point is at the center of this object effect, and then switch on my snapping point, vertex is on, and I'll go somewhere here, perfect center, but I need this point, right? So front, F4, F3, and check everything. Left view, Z, and I can see it's not in the center. It should be somewhere here. Now, perspective again, F3 to come back to shaded mode. Now this is done. And now I have to rotate this thing. So 360, I have 360. So calculator, 360 degree, any circle is basically 360 degree divided by 8 equal to 45 degree angles. So select my model, press E and go to angle, right click, changes to 45, perfect 45 degree. Press shift and create 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Sorry, this is, I need to hide this one now. Hide selection, I can see. Just you have to work on only one. Is it F3 or F4? Okay, F4 is for switching on wireframe. F3 to go back to only wireframe, no shaded. I'm pressing F3 now. So it's only wireframe. Or if you want to have shaded mode plus the wireframe, F4. So now you can see this thing is ready. So it took a little bit time to create the shape because that shape was a bit complex. So it took a little bit time, but I created that thing, and you can see just created once entire shape and rotate. So at once your entire thing is ready. See? Save the file. Just give me a second. I have created a folder for you guys. Where is my 212? Yes, tell me, what is the doubt?
So can you hear me now?
I can hear you. Yes, tell me.
Yeah, so when you're using the line tool, and you're using the lathe option to it to create a shape, but after making the model, if I feel that the model is not looking good and I want to go back to that line option, is it possible to go back? Or
yes, of course. Like this shape, okay. It have a line, you can see, you see this line, right? If you want to go back line, just switch it off, line, go back to line.
Okay.
So that's why we're using all this stack option and everything. If you use this, then you have the option to go back always. But if I just right click and collapse it, now it's become a polygon. Now you cannot go back.
Okay.
So like this will generate everything. You can see, it's just like now my chandelier is ready. I'll save this, where is my path?
So collapsing is like if we are happy with the model, can collapse it. So there will be no option to edit it.
Yes, like collapsing is only and only when you are finished with the model, entire everything is ready, then only collapse. Otherwise, do not collapse it.
Okay.
And I already have a model. I don't know, like I'm not able to open it. Like that's due to some strange reason. I guess some version issue or something. It's showing a preview. But yeah, version issue. Yes. I guess I used some other version for that. So I'm not able to open it. So I'll open that. I'll install Max 2021. That time I'm using 2020. So, and then I'll open it. So it should work perfectly. I'll show you that entire thing, how I created this thing and how modified everything. And it's very simple. It just matter of like, you should know those options and then you can do it very easy. And if you switch on, if I switch on shadow and all, it looks really nice. All shadow, realistic. version. Could you send the installation file by Google Drive or by Dropbox? 2020, the path I use, it was like online installation. Okay, you use torrent, right? So I can send you a torrent file, 2020. Or maybe you can use any version, like you can any version you're finding online, you can use it. That's completely fine. Because I'm planning to upgrade to 2021, 22. So like any version you use, I can open your files then. Yes, we can add light. I'll explain all those things, like add light, because I already have a file ready. I prepared a file with chandelier, light and everything material. So I used a wrong version, I guess. That's why I'm not able to open it. So I'll install the updated version and then I'll open it.
So one more doubt.
Yes.
In gaming, we only use trigons and polygons, right?
Yes.
Triangles
and polygons. Yes. Triangles or rectangles. So there is usually rectangles. Also, we try to convert them into square, like quads. Basically, it should be quad, and we try to keep them as square only. But like there will be 90% cases, like especially hard surface model, like this kind of model, we use like random shapes. That's fine. But like it should be quads and triangles. That's it.
Okay.
So it's like using. So that's okay. That license was like, it was a like student version. So if you want, I can send you some other version with some crack or something. I can send that. Like torrent, a file will be around 8 GB or something, 7-8 GB. So that will be it's better to I'll upload and then you download again. It's better you can just directly download. I'll give you the path. Is this cycles or Eve? I'm talking about EV render, that renderer that in Blender. That's what you're talking about, I believe. Blender option, yes. So EV is basically default renderer in Blender. But in Max and Maya, we have Arnold. You can see there is something called Arnold. So in Arnold, you have all this renderer. I can change the renderer and change it. Our default render is press F9, it will render without any light. But this is not Arnold, this is your scan line. So I have to change the setting and everything and render it out. With Arnold, you can achieve very good quality render within no time. Don't worry, I'll explain all those things. I'll show how to create and everything. And you can see it's pretty simple. It's only the matter of you get the shape right, then duplicate. So once the shape is done, just duplicate it, your mesh is ready. And F4, you can see it looks pretty nice and decent. I'll upload this video plus upload this file also in Moodle, so you can download and check all the files. Okay, and I'll take the attendance, just give me a second. there's something wrong with my file. Again, that thing is not just give me a second, I'll take a screenshot. Okay, I got the screenshot. So I'll update it accordingly. So update this thing. I'll ask, I guess because everybody was winding up everything, so you can't access Moodle. Okay, then send a message to student coordinator mail that you can't access Moodle, but why you have received your login ID password, right? Yes, definitely I can mail it, but we prefer Moodle reason. So everything it will be at one place. And whenever you want, you can always go back and click that module and you can access all the files there. So for you also in future reference, it will be easy. Okay, what happened? Okay, then try this thing out. I'll upload the video and send you the mail and all this thing. And from Monday, whatever the tire schedule, our weekly schedule, will follow that thing because past 2 days all this thing happened, so we are not able to do it on the exact time. So from Monday we'll follow the exact weekly schedule and do it. I guess it was this week it was 3 p.m. So from next week it might be different. Just cross check with the weekly schedule. Okay, I'll see you guys on Monday, and if you have any doubt, you can send me a mail or message or something. I could check if required. We can have a doubt clearing session as well and extra class, and we will discuss everything. Okay. Okay, then I'll see you guys.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, okay. WhatsApp number. Okay, 7 8 9 7 2 6. Okay, this one. You can WhatsApp me, that's fine. Or if you want, you can create a group, add me, and we can if you have any doubts or something, we can discuss there directly. That's absolutely fine. But don't call me after, call me or something after 6, 7 o'clock or 8 o'clock. I'm usually busy. So daytime is fine. Okay. Okay. Bye-bye.